Today, we'll continue the series on AVL trees and talk about deletions. As a quick reminder, we may need to perform fixes when inserting and deleting nodes from AVL trees. This is because for any node, the height of its two subtrees differs by at most one. This value is called the balance factor and is found by taking the height of the left subtree and subtracting the height of the right subtree. I'll use this tree to show examples of deletion. For now, I'm going to completely ignore height and balance factor and only show the different scenarios for deleting nodes. Let's say we want to delete 60. 60 does not have a left child, so we move its right child into its place. Again, this may or may not be balanced, but for now we don't care. Let's do 15 now. In this scenario, the node has no right child, so we move the left child into its place. Lastly, let's delete node 120. This node has both a left and a right child, so we need to find its in-order successor. That is, the node in the tree with the smallest value that is greater than 120. You can see that this is 125. So we move 125 in the place of 120. Now let's go back to our original tree, this time filling in height and balance factor, and I'll show you a few examples of rebalancing after removing nodes. Let's delete 120 again. We move 125 in its place. It now has a height of 3 and a balance factor of 2, which we know breaks our AVL tree property. So we need to perform a fix. Here are the four types of fixes, which are very similar to insertion. We see that we can perform single or double rotations. We analyze the balance factor of the node and the balance factor of its left or right child to determine if the tree is left or right heavy. I'll draw in the subtree of interest, and let's run through the logic. Our balance factor is 2, so this first condition is met. The balance factor of its left child is 0, so both conditions in the first if block are true. We need to perform a right rotation. Back to the full tree, I'll demonstrate a right rotation on node 125. We're back to a balanced AVL tree. Let's do one more example, this time deleting 10. It's a leaf, so we don't need to replace any nodes. Just remove node 10. The height of 15 updates to 1, and the height of 25 updates to 2. Traversing back up the tree, we see we have a violation at node 50, as its balance factor is negative 2. This violation satisfies this if condition. So we perform a left rotation. The result of this rotation is the following tree, a valid AVL tree. The code for delete is similar to insert. We start at the root of the tree and traverse down, looking for the specified key to delete. Once we find it, we perform our three checks. If the node doesn't have a left child, doesn't have a right child, or has two children, in which case we need to find the in-order successor. Continuing on, we update the height of the node as well as its balance factor. We then look for the four fixes we may need to perform. Finally, the runtime of delete is big O of n, as we may need to traverse down the entire tree which, as we discussed in the intro video, is bounded on height by 1.44 times log base 2 of n. That's it for AVL trees. Thank you for watching. I hope this video helps you on your computer science journey. Please like and subscribe.